The Middle East ceasefire is tonight hanging in the balance, with the US accusing Hamas of delaying peace. America's top diplomat is in the region for more negotiations, but says some changes proposed by Hamas are simply not workable.
A burst of light from an aerial bombardment. Hezbollah launched more than 200 rockets into Israel from Lebanon, a retaliatory attack after an Israeli airstrike killed one of the group's top commanders. It has fueled fears of a wider conflict as efforts to end the war on Gaza escalate. US Secretary of State Antony Blinken is in Doha.
Good to see you.
Working with Qatari and Egyptian mediators to secure a peace deal after Hamas proposed changes to it.
Some of the changes are workable, some are not.
According to the terror group, those amendments include the guarantee of a permanent ceasefire and the complete withdrawal of Israeli forces. Under the first phase of the US-led proposal, there would be a six-week temporary pause in fighting, and the IDF would only pull out of populated areas.
Hamas could have answered with a single word: yes. Instead, Hamas waited nearly 2 weeks and then propose more changes.
As fighting rages, a new report from the UN has accused Israel and Hamas of committing war crimes during the October 7 attacks and what has followed.
We are perfectly aware of what was a unique level of destruction and a unique level of casualties in the Palestinian population.
Palestinian health officials say almost 40,000 people have been killed in Gaza since the war began. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.